Well, I sort of knew because, I mean, Daniel and I talked a lot before he said yes. And, you know, like me starting to write it, and I think Stephen all the way up through the filming, he was scared about it. He's talked about this, so I think it's okay to say it. I mean, he found the idea of playing Abraham Lincoln, you know, terrifying, and that, you know, it's like a great way to fail in some spectacular, hideous way, and, you know, with a hat and the beard and everything, and you know, it just seemed impossible on that side of things. So I totally got why he wanted a long time to get ready to do it, and we went through the script 18 or 19 times during the course of that year, over and over and over again. And you know, he's the son of one of England's greatest poets, and the son-in-law of Arthur Miller, and he really is a really spectacular writer himself. So that was a lot of fun. I mean, the three of us used the year, I think, really well. I always wanted him to play the part, so he was always Lincoln in my mind. I always thought...
You weren't involved when Liam Neeson was going to do it.
When I started, Liam was still involved, but then when Liam decided that he wasn't going to do it, I immediately said to Stephen, well, so can we ask Daniel? And Stephen had already asked Daniel, and Daniel had already said no for the second time. And I understand that Leonardo DiCaprio is the person who called Daniel up and said, you're crazy, you have to do this. We went over to Ireland to meet Daniel, and he finally said, okay, maybe, why don't you come over and let's talk about it. And we were in a pub, and I was talking to Daniel, and he was standing up with his head silhouetted against a window. It was around 5 o'clock at night in the evening, and Stephen took an iPhone photograph. Stephen does that with everything. Anything exciting happens, his phone comes out, and he's like, but he took a picture of Daniel, and he emailed it to me, and it's just a silhouette of a head, and you would absolutely think you were looking at one of those 19th century black silhouettes of young Abraham Lincoln. So I finally said to Daniel, I mean, look in the mirror, God is telling you something, you know. You're not only one of the greatest actors ever, but you actually look like this guy, so we don't have to do the rubber stuff, which I think is one of the reasons that the performance is so astonishing, is that, you know, when you put a smear of latex over an actor.
Is there no latex on him?
He's got the ears and the wart.
But that's his nose.
That's, as far as I know, that's his nose. That's his nose. I mean, it's Daniel. One of the weird things during the filming is that he would turn his head a little bit, and it was Daniel Day-Lewis, and then he'd turn his head a little bit, and you'd swear you were looking at one of the Alexander Gardner portraits of Lincoln. And I think you see that in the film. You wind up sort of negotiating, knowing that this is, you know, this incredibly hot British guy, and that it's Abraham Lincoln. I mean, you kind of go back and forth. And I think it's important, I mean, even when it's really well done, you know, there are times when Daniel ages on camera, like these like lines and there's a sort of dark webbing that appears around his eyes. That's not makeup. I mean, that just sort of happens because he gets upset. And great actors do that. It's on the surface of the skin. And if you put, you know, rubber over that, you really kind of cut them off from one of their most important instruments. So I think it's a great thing that the previous big screen Lincoln was Henry Fonda, who, you know, is nothing physically like Lincoln. He made a great Lincoln, but it took a certain amount of weird stuff to get him to look like it.